We have a Surface laptop. I'm not sure, one or two. But yeah, this one has a picture issue. It displays an external screen fine, but no internal screen. So it's either a screen issue or motherboard issue or something else. Keyboard backlight on, and definitely no picture, but it's certainly on. Alright, so this one will be 1769. Surface 1769 is a Sure, so it is a yeah, it's either first or second, but most likely first, okay? It's definitely on, so I should get the IR bit coming up. It's one of the cloth material one. So what can go wrong with this guy? Yeah, it's a super annoying one. Like gluing this guy back after removal. How are we gonna do that? Off, it's on, and nothing yet, so let's see. Weird, eh? How can it lose screen all of a sudden? Problem with this screen is we can remove it, but is it the screen? We're not sure. Is it? It won't be the whole sensor, right? Because it's already on and it's turning on. Run a magnet around it. No difference. Yeah, so we're going to unfortunately give it a go at popping this guy open carefully in a way without cracking, without ripping, if you like. So it's not going to be easy. Excuse the microphone sound, you might hear ruffled patches. It's from the clothing, so we have microphone issues as always. Never a good microphone experience. Okay, so this one's gonna be tricky, but it can be done. Now I did it too shallow, meaning I'm taking the cloth material out except the actual area that I want. So I have to dig a little bit more. Give it a go. Thank you. So I'm working with about 200 degrees and a large nozzle. Yeah, this is what we got to go through. Service your product, Microsoft. Thank you. Oh, fuck. It melted. Shit. Damn. Damn it, we melted the keys. Ah, far out. So annoying. Let's focus on the problem on hand. Photo. We might be able to fix that case issue, I have an idea. But more importantly is this guy. Why am I having so much difficulty pulling this out? So that's usually the touch. Maybe. Take a photo. UFK 1909 1. Try STGDM, STGDM. 13515 06. Alright, nature is calling, I'll have to be back. Okay, let's have another look at the photo. STGDM, was that STGDM? My finger is on it. MSTGDM, okay. MST. MST-GDM-135-1506. A GDM, okay, sorry. Okay, that's it. So that's the screen line, okay. All right, so screen is here, and this is touched in. Visually, there is nothing wrong there. So, let's just plug them back in. I know we haven't got a fan, a thermal, anything. I'll just put this pad there. Okay. That will offer something to this power-hungry motherboard. Okay. Keyboard backlight is on. Yeah, nothing on the screen. Okay. So what could this mean? So there's no picture at all. Wow, working with this screen is going to be a pain, eh? I think I've got a screen. Alright, let's remove this screen assembly. Okay, we do need a strong... So that's a different screw. So that's different, small size. It's different. Different. Like a different, why? No, wait. This one should be okay. Okay, let's get another screen. Yeah, I think we got one, let me check. Same model, okay. If you're wondering where these parts come from, you buy them. This one should already be disassembled, I think. Oh. No? Okay. So what was wrong with this one? Correct screen. There should be another one. Sick. Surface. GTX. Extra spawn spray. Yeah, I think that's it. It's in the same box. Yeah. This one should be working. I feel so rich next to these boxes. They really do look nice and solid feel. Yeah, this is the one I had opened, because I do remember opening up one. Yeah, and that's the one I screwed up there, which is fine. So I can maybe use this one to fix. Oh good, okay. That's what I want to see. That's fine. Okay, so this is my one. Okay, same process. This microphone is not that bad, actually. It does pick up a lot of noise, but that's fine. I'll listen to it later, see if it's okay. Yeah, same. So they put that thermal paste on the lid. I don't even know why I've opened that again before. What did I use for these? Was it this one? Okay, so this is all errors. And the issue is, it's there, it's, which is here. Here we go. So if that's the LCD, and that's the touch. We don't need to connect the touch or camera, etc. Now we need our keyboard. Look at that, we don't have a picture. Doesn't mean there is no picture. Maybe I got the cables wrong. Okay, let's shut it down. Come on, shut down. Okay, it's off. No, nothing on the screen. So this is a motherboard issue. So another screen. Yeah. No picture. Definitely just no picture, because we don't even have a, I mean, anything obvious. So where do we start in terms of diagnosing this fault? All right, let me get my brain together. I'll be back. What can cause screen to not work at all? Like backlight, I can understand being backlight. I can understand being showing a picture, but no backlight. All I can think of is a hall sensor. You know what would be good? Test the client screen. This is... Wait. Yeah, this is the client... Wait a minute. Is this my screen? Because my screen had a crack. Did I put the wrong screen? Okay, shit. Okay, 1 second. Okay, my mistake. I'm sure my screen has cracks. Yeah, I'm a little confused. What the hell happened here? Okay, this is clients. This is my board. This is my keyboard. Yeah, this one has a crack. Is this the one I tested with a crack? Let me try. The one with the crack won't turn on, yeah. Okay. Feel like an idiot, wait 1 second. Yeah, this is my screen. Okay, that's fine. This is the client's motherboard, okay. Yeah, okay. So what I'm gonna do now is try client screen on my one that is dead. This is... Why am I doing this so difficult? Why? Alright. Yeah, this is my computer. My screen. This is my screen. Okay. Now I'm going to try the client screen. Okay. This is the client screen. Which we're getting a blank screen. The easiest solution is to give them their motherboard, right? Technically, yeah. Just clone their data across. And problem fixed. So for air one, we'll give it a different thermal paste. Give it a Do we have any other salami? I should actually just mark everything. Yeah, so that's client screen on my computer. I'm curious, what does it have anyway? Like its specs and whatnot. They didn't actually reset it, okay. This one we got off eBay. The parts, originally. And they couldn't reset because of the screen, okay. The client screen is fine. Perfectly fine, amigos. Okay, this is ours. Yep. Okay, one sec. So, I thought about doing a BIOS swap, motherboard swap, but it's not going to work out. And their one comes up as Surface Laptop 2 128GB i5, and my one comes up as Surface Laptop 1 i5 128G as well. Pretty much the same thing. Well, I don't know what the difference, maybe generation of the CPU? I don't know. Okay. It's like the new iPhone 13 and 14. What is the difference? Software change. It's a bit ugly. Okay, so let me see, do they have a password for this guy? So what we're gonna do, this is the one with the, this is the client with the screen. It's good, okay? So let's put the CPU back in. But before that, let's bring the screen back. So their screen is definitely okay. Okay, so let's do a test of BIOS updates. So we'll need to obtain the username or password for this. But nothing on the screen, obviously. Okay. Did this have a Type-C? Really? They did it in this model? It's kind of bizarre, eh? You will think so. Okay. So we need DisplayPort. Mini DisplayPort to HDMI. I need to mute, stop the video for now. I'll be back. So we're at the login, but we don't have a password. So what I will do is see if I can find any schematics or data sheets for this guy. Then maybe here. Oh, okay, thank God. What is this? Okay. Yeah, all right. Enable signal. Where the hell are we gonna find enable signal? Okay, what is this one? Ah, okay, this is it. This is the LCD panel. Okay, alright. LCD panel. VP3 display switch maybe? Who knows? Ah, here we go, panel enable, okay. Alright, we're looking for this guy. Okay, wow, spot on. Okay, so let's go to microscope like this. Okay, it's a bit awkward. Okay, 1 second. We don't need DSO. Let me see how I'm gonna do this. Okay, that's a big problem. Alright, so let's fix this up. Let me shut the system down properly. So I'll hide the screen. Okay, system just shut down gracefully. Okay, we'll leave that on. Leave the charger on. Let's remove the CPU. Socket, this guy. So we're gonna have to somehow measure. There. Very tight place. Okay, let me clean up my workspace. Okay, we can work with that. Okay, so let me blur the screen first. Or let me see. Let me blur. Where are you? There you are. Okay, just blur that. And motherboard turn on. Oh shit, I forgot to put a heatsink. Okay, let me get that. 1 second. The sausage on there, good. Okay. Okay, we're gonna power on the board. Power is on. Yep. Now, we assume it's on. We don't have a display here, but we have a display there. Yeah, great. And let's go to camera. So, microscope, the multimeter. Okay. Okay, what are we in? Oh well, no, we don't want a whale. Voltage mode. Okay, so let's bring in port view. Okay, so where are we looking at? Okay, looks like there. Okay, here we are. Either we have bad ground. Why don't we have backlight enabled so far? There is nothing. We have 3.3 there. Surely we have 3.3 here. What? I don't understand. Oh, they're not connected, sorry. Display switch. Enable. Enable signal. It's coming from here. Sam logo. Interesting, so it's not coming from there. Go back to here, see if we get it here. No. Okay, why not? So let's see if we can find that area. Visually. So our keyboard connector is here, it's near our keyboard connector, which is here, which is there. Okay. Maybe it's sleeping. I don't think it is. Maybe it was. Hard to get a probe there. How about these guys? Three point three, always on switch. VDD enable. Is that enabled? It's coming from the CPU. No. There is nothing coming here. The CPU is not telling it to turn on. I mean, if you touch these two together, it will turn on. How about here? No. I mean, they can short that and we'll have it, but I don't want to do that. I want to know why it's not getting it. Why is it not getting dough? Why is CPU not sending the enable signal? Has he forgotten it? Okay. What's on the screen now? Is it sleeping? It says no signal. Let me unplug the mini display and reconnect it. No, it is there. And just double check that signal again. Yeah, definitely there is no signal. It's a bit tricky, hey? It's not a cable issue. So what we can do is turn the system off. See if there's a short around there. Okay, so first I'll just check if there is any voltages here, here, here. There's a pulse happening there. Okay, so let's go to now resistance mode. Okay, now so 3 volt is pretty good. Looks fine there. This guy looks fine too. So what is the issue? The issue is I need to go to the toilet again. Alright, so I don't have any idea yet. What is the board doing? Is it currently on? No, it's currently off. So I was looking for a short, right? Okay. Before that, let's have a look at 3P3D panel enable. It comes from where? Display VDD enable. So where is that coming from? Where? On switch. That has to be the on. 1, 2, 3. Panel. Display this switch. A1, B1, C1, okay. Which is panel. A1, A3, A5, okay. Let me check. Why do they use different naming convention? Panel, switch, then this is on. This is the one we're not getting, okay? Yeah. So that's the one not coming. One K resistor. Let's find this guy. So this should be a 1K resistor, but we don't have anything there anyway, right? So it's currently off. We're in the resistance mode. Yeah, that is definitely 1K. I don't know if you saw that. Yeah, you will have seen it. Okay, so that's definitely 1K. So let's check this guy. Why is this guy not coming in? It comes from U30003, this guy, which is the one I was looking at before. Pin number 4. So whichever one, so 2 or 1, we'll turn it on. So 3P, 3VA, voltage always. So this one is going to have voltage regardless if it's on or off, right? So let's have a look at that chip again. So pin number 5. It's pin number 5. Here. So that should have 3 volts then. If it's VA. Yeah. Okay, so that guy is enabled. So, pin number 4 is the output here, which we don't have. So one of these should have a SAM panel logo enable, SOC enable. See if they have a on, what is this, on and off switch? So that's the switch. Display backlight enable, backlight, L backlight. These are all backlights, okay. It comes from the CPU. Let's check 2N1. 2N1. See if any of these have voltage. So at the moment they won't have any voltage, obviously, because the system is currently off. So he will have voltage. And he doesn't have. And he doesn't have. Just double check. Yeah, okay. So we're now going to turn the unit on. Is the unit on? Check on cable is out. Okay, this unit is on. We are in voltage mode. Here, nothing. Here, nothing. Here, we have something. Why is it not being told to turn on? Neither that or that. How come? That's why I think it could be an issue related to the BIOS, because I don't see any issues here. Let me check resistance from either of these. ohms. Is that normal? 51 ohms. Well, it's coming from the CPU, so I'm assuming maybe that's normal. That's like a data line. He goes through this resistor. R330015 is a 200k ohms resistor. What do we have here? ohms. How is that possible? Yeah, it doesn't make sense. Why is that 28 ohms? That should be 200 k ohms. Maybe in circuit, because it's connected through this guy. Yeah, backlight PWM, backlight enables, they're all freaking related to each other. Oh, what a big mess, okay. SOC controls backlight or SAM controls backlight? Maybe in circuit, he behaves like that. I think this guy is normal. Let me check the resistance of this guy on the other one. That's a good way. So, it's a little tricky. Let's see. Okay, so now I'm going to check on the other one. Same. That resistor, was it that resistor? Yeah, 28 ohms. And on the other one, right? Wow, 152 kilo ohms. That doesn't mean that's the fault yet, alright? So, because it's going through, it's also connected to SOC backlight enabled. So let's just take him out anyway. Such a tiny area to work on, it's mental. I'll remove this keyboard connector. We're just going to push him out and measure him outside. Wow. Just like that. Okay. All right, so now let's check his resistance. See? He's okay. So now this guy's resistance, it's basically that guy's resistance. So there is definitely a issue with this guy somewhere. We're still not gonna have a backlight, so let alone picture. So let's have a look at, so we have an issue with this guy. Comes from the CPU. How about this one? SOC, what's his resistance? So he's at the top. He looks alright. So his resistance, as per schematics, should be 49k. Oh, he looks okay. There we go, it's fine. So he's not the short. Let's continue. So he's also connected. Anywhere else? No, nowhere else. If you connect them together, it will always be on. Let's just see what happens. I'm curious. It's not going to work, obviously, but... So we don't have SAM backlight enable, or picture enable. Okay, so we have the motherboard on. Obviously no picture yet. Okay, so the board is off. What can we check next? I mean, could this guy be playing up? It's hard to tell. He's not getting the signal. VG. So, SOC display VDD enabled. Pin number 1 and 2. Let's check those resistance on the other one, right? Here. 1 and 2. On my one, the resistance are 1 29. This is same panel. SOC display enable, and here display VDD enable. What do we get there? No, that's bad. Shouldn't be 12 ohms. That's not good. Let's bring the other motherboard. So here, that's the SOC. 200K. That's the same as what I had on my one. Here. Why am I checking it there? Let me check it at the top. Getting OL. Whereas on my one, here, one kilo ohms. This is reading as 1 kilo ohm. Yeah. That is correct. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and put that resistor back at the bottom. This guy. Let's see anything. head. Now let's just swap this guy out. Such a bad area to work with. It's right next to the connector. How am I going to do this? Okay, I can reduce the airflow. And point it away from there. Now, this is a large muzzle, that would work. Put a cap on tape, regardless if it will do any job or not. Change the head. Okay, that's in. Now, this is a real difficult mate. Okay. We gotta repeat the same procedure on the other working one. Hopefully we won't damage anything. the dot being on the top left. Pray and pray. I wonder if the chip is in the right location. I can't even tell. Is it? I have no freaking idea. Maybe. Just give it a quick touch. Another thing. Okay. Power on. So that chip is actually good because we still don't have a screen. Well, it's cheaper to say that. I haven't got the screen connected. Okay, I'm an idiot. No, I'm not an idiot. It's just the late hours. This job is difficult. Very small room to work with. So many other little problems. I'm doing my best. Okay, so it's definitely off. Okay. Now power on again. Hey, there we go. Fixed. Okay. So it was a good thing I did not run a wire, because that chip was internally, I believe, shorted. Therefore, had I supplied 3 volts, it may have damaged the CPU, I'm not sure. I can't guarantee. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Now, first thing first, in such cases, we won't come back to this job again in a long time. So let's quickly go ahead and order this guy. Keep it in the inventory. So where the hell do I find you? Okay. Obsolete. Okay, how about you? Okay, I'll keep an eye on this one, and I will definitely order this guy, okay, for future. Well, we got a new problem, right? Unnecessary one. Fuck. Let's fix up this guy. Put him back in properly. Thank you, Salami. He's done a good job. Put some new thermal paste. I'm very cramped in space. I can't believe it. Okay. 6:37. Shit. Time flies. Okay. I've got to go in. So let me see. Okay. So that will be it. I'm going to clean up this and finish up this job. That will be that. So we'll put this over there. Now what do we do about this keyboard, right? So mainly these two and escape. Now let's have a look at our key. It's fine. The switch is fine. Switch is fine. Alright, we'll make a second part video, okay? Nice. Alright, let's end the video here for this. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to support this channel.